is back when, I believe it was Peter, was trying to stop Jesus from going to the cross. He said, I got to go to Jerusalem, I'm going to die. And Peter said, no, no, What did Jesus tell him? Get behind me, Satan. You don't say anything to me, God. You're speaking the things of me. Praise God and come on in here and give him God the glory and glad to do my city and tell them I love them. Because if I don't love them, I'll never see Jesus.
That's what it says in the Word is all about. It's just like the Bible. Mm-hmm. You know,
yeah.
If you take a guy, you know, you start off and lift it, you know, 100 pounds, and he keep working, pretty soon he's going to be lifting 300 pounds. Now, the more you study the Word, the stronger you get in Christ. You know, and, you know, that's what that verse is talking about. You know,
yes.
And you won't suffer that after you wait. Your muscles and everything will be tight for a minute.
Yeah.
But the more you do it, the use of your muscles get to that. Uh-huh. Same thing with the Word of God. Right. You know. Some of it you don't like it when you read it.
Yeah.
You know. But then after you read it, you keep reading. But the Word is right. You know, the Word can't lie. My other stuff is going on. But I've learned now that obedience is better than sacrifice.
Yeah.
So I'm good.
Yeah. That's the key verse right there.
Amen.
Obedience is better than sacrifice.
Amen.
Well, Lord, I'm going to give you all the money I've got. And Jesus, well, will you go down there to the corner? And there's a guy standing down there, and I want you to tell him about me.
Amen.
Well, Lord, I'm going to go in the house, and I'm going to put $1,000 in there.
Amen.
So I don't want your $1,000. I want you to go right down on the corner. And tell that sister there about me how to get saved. Obedience is better than sacrifice. Well, I heard somebody on the game show said, the doctor told me I got cancer, I'm gonna die in 7 days. He said, I got plenty of money. What would you do those 7 days? Some of them give me a different answer. I said, Lord, have mercy. Someone said, well, I'm going to go to the nightclub and watch the strippers. I said, Lord, have mercy. You only got 7 days. You can't take it with you. Nobody said nothing about giving the poor nothing. You're going to go and ball and go to Las Vegas and do all these things. But then the next 7 days, I'm going to live it up. Can't take it. Praise the Lord. So that's the way it is. We don't have 7 days. You see, you don't know because today is the day. Tomorrow not promised to nobody. What I do with what I got today counts. Next verse.
Seeing it is a righteous thing of God to recognize tribulation that troubles you.
Is it?
And to you who are troubled and with us when the Lord Jesus shall be revealed from heaven with his mighty angels.
In other words, he said it's a good thing. That you suffer these tribulations with us. We're all in this thing together. Paul is telling them. It's a wonderful thing. God is looking at your tribulations. And he's going to get the revenge. Vengeance belongs to the Lord, Jesus Christ. And he's coming with his angels to bring vengeance on them that brought tribulation to us, that would not accept him as the Savior. My Lord, that's going to be a time.
That word recompense means to turn the record. You know?
Right. It means to pay.
Verse 8 in
explaining the problem, they can bring it to them that know not God, and they're obeying not the gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ.
And coming back, taking vengeance on all of those that will not believe the gospel. See? That want to do their own thing.
The vengeance of fire. Fire can destroy, or what was the other thing fire can do?
Fire can destroy. It's a pendulum.
That's the way the Lord always came back. No man was going to face God.
That's right.
You know. So, but every time he came back, there was some type of fire.
Some type of flame.
He said the first time with what? Water?
Water, yeah.
Noah's days?
Yeah.
Second time with fire. Vengeance.
Yeah.
Yeah. Lake of fire.
Yeah, cleansing agent and a purifier. Because those are the two, spiritual definitions of fire, right?
What did John say? He said, I baptize them with water unto repentance. That's all I got. But the one coming after me, gonna baptize with the Holy Ghost and with fire. Revive us, O Lord, fill our hearts with thy love, and so be recounted from fire above. That Holy Ghost comes to him, praise God, and cleanse out every wicked, evil thing that is in the heart. A new heart. Praise God. Any questions? Any comments?
Okay, verse 9.
Okay.
Who shall be punished with everlasting destruction from the presence of the Lord and from the glory of his house?
Cannot stand before the presence of God in his glory. Even now, we can't look on him. We can't stand in his presence because we have to be changed. And we're going to be changed. How soon? The moment in the twinkle of an eye. Mortal shall put on immortality. And it's going to happen. Because God is not a man he can lie.
Mm-hmm.
Amen.
Well, that's what the verse says. We shall. God promises this to punish. He promises this to punishment, everlasting destruction. No way back, everlasting.
Yeah. Refuse to accept the gift of God in the person of his Son. The Word that became flesh and walked among men and did what no other man could do. Proving that he was God walking around in the flesh. And praise God he has done to us. And we are his witnesses.
Amen.
He has made us new creatures.
Yeah.
Old things are.
That's the way.
Behold, all things are become. Don't tell me you say and keep going on going out to the nightclubs, strip clubs, all these things. By your fruit.
Right.
You know this. Praise the Lord.
Okay,
go ahead, son.
Okay, verse 10. But he shall come to be glorified in his saints. And to be admired in all them that believe, because our testimony among you was believed in that day.
Praise the Lord. Can you see me standing up before God Almighty, and he's magnified and he's happy to see you?
Amen. That's good. Thing.
And that brings glory to him. Brightness. Oh, my Lord. You mean to tell me that God is glad that I'm glorifying God Almighty? Mm-hmm. Come and praise God to get glory in what he has had done, that we accepted his sacrifice and died on the cross for us.
Yeah.
Yeah. Not willing that any should perish. Oh, like this. That did it. Okay.
Wherefore also we pray always for you, that our God would count you worthy of this calling, and fulfill all the good pleasure of his goodness and the work of faith and power.
Yeah, God just worried. Man, I don't know about you, but I feel like dancing right now. Praise the Lord. Making us worthy, pleasing him, made us for his own pleasure. And in the end, my Lord, he's good. I can't even fathom. I can't get it in me. What really what I am to God. He's trying to tell me, but my mind just can't get it.
Right. Right. Well, let me ask you a question.
Yes.
Well, that's a classic question.
Okay.
Do we know that we feel when we're not pleasing God? I'm gonna keep
And then when they come to see you, you set the example.
Yeah, that's right.
If they don't never come to see you, you can't set the example.
Yes.
Amen.
Amen.
Oh, bless the Lord, oh my soul.
Amen.
Any other comments before we shut down?
Enjoy it.
God bless the saints.
Always enjoy it.